Welcome back to Hit Points Gaming. I'm Chris and
Corey.
We're here today with a flash review, which is a review we do of a game in under 5 minutes of today's Flick 'em Up by Pretzel Games. So we have 5 minutes to tell you what this game is about, what we think about it, some rules, and I'm ready.
Ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. Let me first start by asking you, did you ever play Cops and Robbers growing up?
Absolutely.
Yeah?
Yes.
How so?
I always was usually the robber. Okay. It just was easier for me to run around and...
Run around the house and, you know, cause mayhem.
Right.
I had the Legos, I had the whole, like, you know, sheriff attacking, you know, the bank robbers. So we've all had that experience growing up.
Yes.
That's what this game is.
Okay.
You know, for us older now, and now we can relive that experience. So in Flick 'em Up, there's two sides. You're either the law-abiding sheriffs, or you're the robbers doing whatever you want based on one of 10 different missions.
Okay.
The rules are pretty simple. You've got one of two things. You can either move one of your pawns when it's your turn by using this movement action. You flick it, and if you don't hit anything, you get to move to that location. Okay? Once you're there, because you have two actions on your turn,
Right. The
other thing you can do is actually shoot these awesome little bullets. Depending on which side you want your guy to shoot from, you put it next to him, and then you flick.
Good shot.
Thank you.
Right.
And do a point of damage to the other person. Turns alternate by flipping over this hat to show that they've activated, which is a pretty nifty thing with the components. And you keep going until either all the characters of the opposing team are dead. I think they have 2 or 3 hit points. Or you satisfy the winning condition. That's the rules right there. Pretty simple to teach anybody.
Yes. However, there is one rule that we talked about just before we started this.
Right.
Flicking. The game is called Flick 'em Up. There is a way to flick, and that's what they point out in the rules.
Right. There's no, like, you know, flicking it with your thumb, resisting it to get that extra power. There is a specific way that you need to flick this.
And I think that's important because the game, I don't know if I like that or not, because if you, you know, you do this thing with your finger and flick, you kind of lose some accuracy, but you gain some power. Mm-hmm. But these pieces are really small, so, like, as you just hit that guy, if they fall over very easily, I think if you flicked, and I guess the reason they don't allow you to do that, is because then you're going to mess up these pieces on the board. You're going to send these barrels flying, the barrels of hay.
The fence is going
to
break.
Yeah, like, there's no reason for you to power up. You just do this really easy flicking motion with your finger.
Sure, that's what they tell you to do.
Yeah.
But then we try and figure out how to get the most power out of just that little flick. Because I want to hit this cactus with a bullet and explode it and have it land over there.
Right.
Which will then cause other terrain to hide behind. It's a fun part about this game.
Yes.
Every scenario shows you how to set up the map for that level, which is really sharp. And every scenario will also introduce either a new rule or a new ability, which you have over here.
The rifle helps you, like, actually aim. So when you put this down, you put your bullet inside of it, and it does. I mean, I was just playing with this before. It makes your accuracy increased, you know? So how do you really increase someone's accuracy? Well, you give them the rifle. This is perfect.
I like it. Yes, plus if someone is really bad at the game, like, let's say my mom comes by, let's just give her the rifle.
Yeah. And it helps, it increases the difficulty for other people because now they have to be a little better. But it gives you a little handicap. And the one thing I don't like about it is, I love this table. Let me tell you that.
I
love the table because it's got that lip on it. You know, if you're playing this on your kitchen table and you flick this thing too hard,
boom, I gotta go after it. And then
good luck finding it.
Underneath the countertop table, I gotta move stuff.
Yes.
I get mad. Mom, why didn't you use the rifle? You shot the bullet off the table. Doesn't matter. If you have a table like this, perfect.
Right. Or you just don't play crazy. I mean, the bullet is smaller than a dime and the move piece is about the size of a quarter, so they are small to find. Just don't go crazy. You don't need a table like this. Just don't
go crazy.
Hard.
Don't have too much fun is what you're saying.
Right. And that's what this game lets you do.
Right.
You have a lot of fun playing this game. I really like it.
Absolutely.
It's fast. It's easy to pick up. And you can play it multiple times. You can play the scenarios, or you can just maybe put some stuff on the table and set it up. You know, randomly create a board.
That's true. That's true. Some things we haven't talked about is this cool little tray here where you can keep track of your actual characters and their hit points. And then when you're done, you can just put them in this little hole in the back. See?
Cool.
Right?
There's no bottom to it, but yeah, it puts it away.
It puts it away, so it's a nice and clean table.
Right.
Another thing that you can do I didn't mention is you can actually go inside of the building. There's special rules for that where you can shoot from outside. You can even do like a standoff rule. When you go inside, you have to go a certain number of paces.
Okay.
And then you shoot off. So it really gets you in that feel I would definitely recommend putting some background music to this.
Yeah, absolutely. Right.
It's a lot of fun.
The pieces are heavy duty. I mean, this is a nice piece of cardboard, nice base.
Yeah, I guess one of the negatives in the beginning that people were saying was it's pretty expensive because of the wooden components. Well, Pretzel Game actually has come out with a plastic version, which is a bit cheaper, so that's always another option. And that's our 5-minute flash review of Flick 'Em Up.